Bath Ironworks has once again permanently welded its part in military history. Today, the Navy christened a first-of-its-kind destroyer named after former Chief of Naval Operations, Admiral Elmo Bud Zumwalt, Jr., a man who President Clinton called the conscience of the Navy at his funeral. This ship will now begin its service to America.
Two of Admiral Zumwalt's children broke the bottle against the bow to begin the career of their father's legacy, the USS Zumwalt, now the Navy's largest destroyer.
I know my father would be deeply moved by the majesty of the vessel that we see before us. He would be humbled that it bears his name.
Bath Ironworks crews began work on the ship back in 2009. It will now be floated down the Kennebec River.
She is a statement of confidence. Confidence in her builders, in every weld, every wire, every line of her bow. And confidence as well in those who will take her from us on their way to the deep waters of a dangerous world.
Secretary of the Navy Ray Mabus says it couldn't hold a more sacred namesake.
Elmo Zumwalt was a leader. He was a trailblazer, and he was a pioneer for things like justice.
Zumwalt became the youngest chief of naval operations and is considered a pioneer in helping women and minorities advance their military careers. Secretary Mabus says Zumwalt knew the importance of people, not just technology.
And that's what he devoted his career to, and that's why it's so fitting that that this ship is named for that, for him.
The $7 billion ship is the first of three in its class to be built.
This ship will allow us to do what the Navy uniquely does, and that is provide presence around the world. Not being in the right place just at the right time, but in the right place all the time.
The ship's motto is Peace Through Power, which was the same motto for the USS Dewey, a Bath-built ship that Admiral Zumwalt commanded earlier on in his career.